Nalla Narasimha Reddy Education Societies, Group of Institutions, Integrated Campus. This is Dr. G. Subbarao. In today's session, I'm going to explain about the importance of petrology from Unit 1, Introduction and Weathering of Rocks, as a part of the subject Engineering Geology. Let us go to the topic, importance of petrology. What is petrology? The study of rocks in all their aspects, including the mineralogies, the texture, the structure, origin, and its relationship to other rocks is called as petrology. We know very well that rocks are divided into three groups based on their origin, namely igneous rocks, for example granite, syenite, chornokite, gabbro, dolerite, rhyolite. All these rocks are belonging to the group igneous rocks. And sedimentary rocks, examples shale, sandstone, limestone, etc. All these rocks are belonging to sedimentary rocks. And metamorphic rocks, which include quartzite, marble, slate, etc. So rocks are divided into three groups, namely igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic, based on their origin. What are igneous rocks? Igneous rocks are formed when hot molten material called magma, which solidifies. Otherwise, igneous rocks form through the cooling and crystallization of molten rock material. Simply, igneous rocks are formed when hot molten rock material solidifies. If the molten material is solidified below the earth surface, then it is called as magma. Otherwise, if it comes out and solidifies above the surface of the earth, is known as lava. That means the difference between magma and lava is how the molten material is solidified, and it is very clearly shown in the picture. The molten material is semi-solid in nature and includes liquids, gases, and some earlier formed crystals. The molten material is also consists of volatiles and elements like oxygen, silica, aluminum, calcium, sodium, potassium, iron, magnesium, etc. These are some of the igneous rocks. Can have a glance of granite, junite, syenite, dolerite. The importance of igneous rocks, if we consider, granite especially is used for kitchen tops, and also it is used for the construction of monuments, bridges, office buildings, aggregates, flooring purpose, and interior decoration. Granite rock looks smooth and shiny then it is polished. That is why it is mostly used for flooring purposes. The weathering and erosion of igneous rock produces very rich and productive soils for growing plants. It's another important aspect. The pumice can be used as a bath scrub. We can rub the pumice igneous rock on the foot so that the dead cells will be erased and new cells forms. So pumice can be used as bath scrub. And granite can be cut into desired shape and can be used as a curb stone. Another rock, diorite, which was used since ancient times as a decorative artwork. Sedimentary rocks, which are formed due to weathering and erosion of the pre-existing rocks. That means sedimentary rocks are formed due to igneous rocks due to weathering and erosion process. Sedimentary rocks are classified on the basis of the character of the material and the process which leads to its deposition. So, in addition, the depositional environment plays a major role in the formation of sediment rocks. That is, deposited the material by wind action or water action. If we see the classification of sediment rocks, can be divided into gravax, chert, siltstone, arkose, conglomerate, mudstone or claystone, sandstone, shales, breccia, limestone and dolomite. We can see all the sediment rocks, especially sandstones, gravax, limestones, shales in the picture and how they appear. Coming to the importance of sedimentary rocks, sedimentary rocks tells us what the earth's surface was like in the past. Sedimentary rocks usually contain fossils that tell us about the animals and plants, or sediment rocks show the climate in an area. Sediment rocks are also important because they may contain water for drinking purpose, that's aquifers, or the presence of oil and gas. Limestone and sand can help us in making cement, which is important point for foundation part. Fuel is one of the major source of fuel, which comes from coal. Coal is a sedimentary rock that is formed through compaction of plant debris and even animal debris. Coming to metamorphic rocks, these are formed through the transformation of pre-existing rocks. Here, pre-existing rocks means igneous rocks as well as sediment rocks under increased temperature and pressure conditions. This process of transformation is known as metamorphism. Formation of metamorphic rocks from pre-existing rocks, either igneous or sedimentary, is controlled by a few parameters, especially the composition of the rock, the temperature conditions, the pressure conditions, and the chemical active fluids. These are the main important parameters which control the formation of metamorphic rocks from the pre-existing rocks. If we see the picture, gneiss is the best example for a metamorphic rock, and schist, another important metamorphic rock. Apart from gneiss and schist, we too find quartzite, amphibolite, phyllite, eclogite, condolite, marble, slate, or some other important metamorphic rocks. Coming to importance of metamorphic rocks, especially quartzite and marble, these are mostly commonly used for building materials and artwork. Marble is also used for statues and decorative items. Even the Taj Mahal is made from marble. Gneiss, which is used as a building material and also used for flooring purpose, ornamental stone, facing stone, and for some surface walls. Slate, another important metamorphic rock, which is very fine grained, foliated metamorphic rock that is formed by the alteration process of shale by low grade metamorphism. Its use especially as a roofing material, flooring material, and also for grinding purpose. Overall, importance of petrology from civil engineering point of view is it provides a proper concept and logical basis for interpreting certain properties, structure, and chemical composition of rocks. Properties reveal the type of rocks which are suitable for various engineering operations, and metamorphic rocks provide information about the composition of the earth and the mantle. The study of petrology is very important for a civil engineer in selection of building stone or road metal. These metamorphic rocks reflect directly or indirectly in the production and the redistribution of heat within the earth. The study of petrology is a fundamental aspect to understand in large scale dynamics of our planet. Thank you.